Urban. She has a podcast. She invited an author named Gretchen Rubinon. And she talks about four tendencies of kind of your personality types. And it just hit me like, okay, so these four personality types, so I'll write this name on the board. I totally recommend checking it out. Do the little quiz. Find out what personality you are, because this it will help you be able to do the whole 30. Kind of figure it out like, okay, I'm this kind of person, so I can't. Anyway, so Melissa, who designed it, she's what's called a folder. Everything's black and white. You do these roles, you do this, and you do it. I am not that. Another one is a questioner. You always question things, you have to kind of ask things, make sure you understand it. And then the third one is an obliger. And then the fourth one is a rebel. So these all kind of are personality traits of how you meet your kind of your inner and your outer expectations. So if someone asks you to do something, for me, I came up as a rebel. So that totally makes sense why this whole 30 does not work for me, because I fight with my inner expectations and then I fight when people tell me to do something. So for me, I have to have a sense of freedom and kind of make it my choice. So I kind of have to manipulate the whole 30 just a little bit to kind of make it feel like it's mine, where if someone tells me what to do, and then I struggle with myself, I just was like, forget it. So once you kind of have a realization of what your personality trait is, then it really helps you be able to be successful in any habit-changing form that you do for the rest of your life. And so this week, really, I'm trying to kind of dive more into it, so I will be ready and hopefully can do this whole 30 with you guys. It's my goal. I can do it. So check out, I'm going to write that in on the board for you. Love it. So her name is
kids, so that even as they go on, I'm not trying to push them into some weird diet thing, but just healthy habits. And that's what we want to really get. That's the base of all of this, is healthy habits. So I did give you a handout. Don't feel like you have to read it verbatim. I'm going to kind of tell you just some of the stuff that I'm adding to what's already in here. Okay. So number one, eat slowly and analyze your hunger. You guys, there's a great article by Precision Nutrition. You might not know, but Precision Nutrition is an awesome nutrition company that we're tied into. And we actually do a daily email nutrition lesson with them. So you can do a separate nutrition program through us with Precision Nutrition. And you get this daily email lesson, and it's a year-long training, and it's excellent information. But they have a great article called All About Eating Slowly. And it really talks about the benefits of eating slowly. You're going to digest better. You're going to hydrate better. You're going to have easier weight loss. You're going to maintain your weight.
and you're definitely going to be more satisfied. When you eat fast, you're going to have poor digestion, you'll increase your weight gain, and you're not going to be as satisfied. So eating slower is the better way to go. Also, you have to analyze your hunger. Sometimes we're not really hungry. Sometimes we're bored. Sometimes we're sad. Sometimes we're mad. Okay, so we gotta really check in. Are we physiologically hungry or are we emotionally hungry? And as women, that's a big one that we deal with. So remember, it takes about 15 to 20 minutes for the signal of fullness from the stomach to travel up and tell the brain, hey, we're done. And when we eat fast, we can almost double the amount that we take in that 15 to 20 minutes, right? If you're eating fast, 15 to 20 minutes go by, you're eating so fast you don't realize that you're full, then you get overfull. When you're done eating, you should feel good, you should feel nourished, not like you gotta lay back and unbutton the top pant, right? Okay, there's some great books. I'm always about reading a book in conjunction when you're doing workout and fitness program. Elizabeth Hartwig, the one who did our Whole 30 program, she wrote a book called Food Freedom Forever. Excellent book. I have it on my Amazon books so I can listen to it. This woman really understands what it's like to have these issues with food and how to break it. There's another great book, Am I Hungry? By Michelle May. She tells you that you draw an imaginary line at your kitchen. And before you step foot in there for something that you're hungry for, you have to ask yourself, am I hungry? Now you may say no, and then go in there anyway and eat whatever you were gonna eat, but at least you started to ask yourself. The point is that the more you do this, the more you stop and ask, am I hungry before you eat that food, your mind's gonna have to answer the question. And so it's gonna go, well, no. And then the next step is for you to go, well, why am I wanting this food? Well, I'm angry at my husband, or I'm frustrated because I had a long day. Okay, well, can you go take a walk? And so it leads you through this step process of how to get away from frustration to hunger versus I'm frustrated. What am I feeling and what does that mean and how can I take care of it besides eating? Okay, another really good book is called Mindful Eating. And then another good book is Intuitive Eating. These are all really good books that I just like to give you some options to help us really tap into how are you feeling versus are you actually needing food. Okay, next, number two, kind of ties into number one, stop eating when you're 80% full. You won't be able to do this if you don't follow the first rule, right? So pretend your stomach is like a balloon. And I don't want you to be so hungry that it's like the very first time you pulled the balloon out of the package and it's all shriveled up. But I also don't want your stomach to be so full like a balloon like it's gonna pop, right? Those are the no's. We want your stomach to get hungry to a point of like a level 2 or 3. So you just started to put a little tiny air in it, right? That's as hungry as you wanna get. And as full as you wanna get is maybe about a 7 or an 8, where you can feel that you filled your balloon with some air, but it's not near ready to pop. It could still take more air in. That's a really good mental visual. Okay, moving on. Number three, eat a palm-sized portion of protein at your meals. Okay, that's about 21 grams. So that's a quick, easy equivalent that you can kind of relate to. Most of our shakes, most of the scoops are about 20, 21 grams. That's perfect. That's a palm-sized protein portion. When you're having a snack, consider maybe having 7 to 14 grams of protein, or a third to a half of a hand. Or if you're really hungry, you can still go ahead and have that full palm size. That's a really good habit to get into, is when you're eating, am I having a palm size of protein at my meals? And do my snacks comprise of a third or a half? So maybe this is one cheese stick, or maybe it's two rolls of turkey, nitrate-free lunch meat, right? Okay, moving on. Eat a fruit or vegetable at every meal and snack. You want that rainbow. Your plate should look pretty like a rainbow. Basically, your vegetables, you can go more with those vegetables because they're only about 25 calories per serving. A fruit is double, okay? So yeah, they're more calories, but fruit still has a wonderful nutrient profile. They still offer lots of fiber and lots of vitamins and minerals too. Okay. Remember, they're good sources of our vitamins and minerals. They're a great source of fiber, fruits and vegetables are. And that's gonna help you with what? A healthy gut, right? It'll prevent constipation, it'll help you digest your food. Also, did you know that fiber is your probiotics food? So have you heard the term prebiotic? Prebiotics are just food for your probiotics. And basically, it's fiber for the good bacteria to eat on, okay? All right, moving along, we wanna eliminate processed carbohydrates. You guys, if it doesn't have a face, if it doesn't fly, come from the ground, or have legs, it's a processed carbohydrate, okay? If it's in a box, yeah, that's a good indication it's processed. So you know, your sugars, your refined sugars, things that don't look like how God intended them. Okay, what you wanna focus on though are complex carbohydrates, things that are gonna stick with you, digest slowly, help you feel fuller longer, okay? Oatmeals, potato, quinoa, beans, legumes, fruits and vegetables again. We do need those carbs to maintain our muscles and our energy, okay? That's important. But there's a best time to eat the carbs. And what do you think those two times are? The two best times to eat your carbs?
Post-workout
in the morning, perfect, yeah. Breakfast means you're going to break the fast. So if you've been sleeping for 6 to 8 hours, you've been fasting. So you wanna break the fast. And then after your workout, when you work out, your cells become more receptive for glucose, okay? And when you've worked out and lifted weights, you also burn through your glucose stores in your body. So the muscle stores glucose as what? What's that term? Do you guys know?
Glycogen.
It's a storage form of carbohydrates in the body called glycogen. You heard of glycogen before? That's the technical term for stored carbohydrates in your body. When you work out, you burn through that. And so after the workout, we want to have a protein shake. We want to have some simple carbohydrates like a banana and some protein to get in to put the glucose back into the cells, and then the protein portion helps to repair the muscles, right? So glucose is your carbohydrates, amino acids, proteins build your muscles. You need both of those to put the repair back in there, okay? All right, so moving along, the next thing I'm focused on is healthy fats. So gone are the days where you used to be fat-free. And I know my email says be fat-free, but I just needed something cute that wasn't taken on Gmail. So, and I mean fat from the body. I want to get rid of that fat from the body. Okay, but healthy fats, you guys, there's monounsaturated and polyunsaturated. Big words, right? Basically, omega-3s and omega-6s. Those are the essential fatty acids. However, the American diet has a lot of omega-6s already. So the snacks that I was snacking on earlier, I have some beet crackers, I have some macadamia nuts, and if you look on the package of them, they have sunflower or canola oil in them that they utilize as part of the ingredients. Those are omega-6s. And this can be an inflammatory issue, so that's why it's important to read. A lot of the chips or snacks we get, even if they're healthy or gluten-free, will be cooked in or roasted in. Sometimes these canola oils or safflower oils, those are omega-6s. So our diet does consist of a lot of inflammatory oils. So if you get nuts, what's the better way to do your nuts? Dry roasted, right, or raw, right? So that you're not adding any more of those omega-6s in. So the omega-3s are things like walnuts, olive oil or olives, flax seeds. Those are good, healthy omega-3 fats that you want to make sure you're taking in. But here's a confusing thing. We have always said saturated fats you want to stay away from, right? Well, what plant is a saturated fat? You guys know? Coconut. Yeah, that's a saturated fat. However, it contains medium chain fatty acids. You guys may have heard of those, okay? They're a really unique fat and they bypass the liver and they go immediately into the bloodstream to be utilized for energy. So diets high higher in medium chain fatty acids are going to help promote you feeling fuller longer and assist with weight loss. Okay. Now trans fats, have you heard of that term, trans fatty acids? Okay. You find those in margarines, you find those in donuts, cookies, cakes, and other baked goods. Okay. That, what's that? Well, it may taste good at the moment, but you know, moment on the lips, lifetime on the hips. All right, so those trans fats, they act like saturated fat, and they can actually raise the bad cholesterol and reduce your good cholesterol. So the bad cholesterol is LDLs, right? The good cholesterol is HDLs. Think of heaven starts with an H, so HDLs is the good cholesterols that you want. Okay. So those trans fatty acids, that's a recipe for disaster, and it can send you into a whole bunch of metabolic complications. You don't want to cause any more problems with how your body takes in glucose, and trans fatty acids can actually do that. They can also affect how you take in good healthy fats. There's this term called plastic, and I don't mean the plastic that, you know, things come in, but it means hard. And trans fatty acids can take your cell membrane, which is made of fatty tissue, it can make it hard, and then it doesn't permeate or doesn't allow nutrients in as well. So that's why we want the healthy, good fats in. So think twice before you have that donut, that cake, or that extra cookie. Okay, 7, eliminate caloric beverages. Let's not be drinking our calories. Let's make sure we're eating our calories. But the big thing is the water. Drink half of your body weight in ounces. So whatever you weigh, divide that by 2, and that's the number of ounces you're gonna drink in your water. Why is this? Some people think this is a bunch of malarkey, this whole water thing, and oh, 8 glasses a day. They did a science experiment and found out that women lose about 2 liters, men lose about 3 liters a day. So that's where we come up with, and 1 liter is equivalent to about, what did I say, 34 ounces? So that's where that 64 ounces at a base level comes in. When you talk, when you breathe, when you go to the bathroom, when you sweat, you're losing your water. At minimum level, you have to put those 2 liters back in. That's your 64 ounces. If you're not good with water, please start with that. Please start with the 64 ounces and then take a look at what it would be to do half of your weight in ounces, okay? All right. Sneaky, fun ways to get that water in. And spread it out, you know? Make it a habit to do it in the morning. Make a habit to drink some before your workout. Make a habit to drink it during your workout. Make a habit to drink it after. Now you're spreading it out, and you're not loading yourself up with all this water at the end of the night that you're supposed to drink. And remember, the more you drink, the more you regulate your temperature well, which is important on hot days that we're coming into, right? The more you drink water, you are going to have better energy. Yeah, your body and even all the movements will work better, right? You're hydrated. Okay, supplements, number eight. Plan and prepare your meals in advance. This is huge, you guys. What's the expression? If you fail to plan, you plan to fail, right? Okay, so it does take a little bit of time and energy. So a couple things. Take some time each week or weekend, set it aside. I used to do like a 2 to 3 hour block. I would go get myself some movies and put it on my little DVD TV in the kitchen, and I'd have something in the oven, something on the stove, and I'd be chopping stuff. So it was kind of a fun time for me to like catch up on movies I haven't seen in a while. And then you gotta have those Tupperware containers, not the big ones, but the small ones that you can load up for your week of lunches, or load up for your lunch and dinners. It makes a world of difference when you can wake up in the morning and grab and go, rather than stressing every day, what am I gonna eat for breakfast? What am I gonna eat for lunch? What am I gonna eat for dinner? Another really good thing to do is utilize one of the meal prep services, ReadyLunchbox.com. There's Green Chef. I love Green Chef. There's Home Chef. What's the one you use, Rach? Or the one that you have the coupon for?
HelloFresh.
Oh, HelloFresh, yeah. Blue Bonnet. There's Freshly, which are meals that are already frozen. They come to you, they're organic, and you just microwave them for people who need quick, healthy meals.
So these services, Green Chef, I love. I get a protein and a vegetable, but it's meals I never would make. But they're so much fun, and it's 30 minutes. And what I love about it is everything is already there. I don't have to go search for an onion or this ingredient or this certain spice. Everything comes to me, and I've got at least 3 meals a week, which are going to take me 30 minutes to make, and boom, I'm done. And when you come home and you're tired late at night and you're just like, oh, I just don't feel like making anything, I want to eat whatever's in front of me, if I sit there and I go, it's only 30 minutes, it's only 30 minutes, before I know it, it's made. So that helps out a lot. Okay, number 9, supplements. You guys, supplements are a supplement to help you support your system. They're not in place of anything. Thanks, Brooke, for turning the air back on. A daily vitamin helps you pick up the nutrients you might be missing. Do we all eat perfectly every day? No, we don't, okay? So the B vitamins are really important for women especially. Make sure your multi has a good B or get a separate B complex. Us women definitely need those B vitamins. But the multi is going to pick up all those little other things, your A's, your C's, your D's, okay? Omega-3s help reduce inflammation. It helps with your skin and your hair, okay? Also helps with your HDLs, keeping those HDLs up and getting those LDLs down. Omega-3s help to package up the LDLs and they send them away, okay? Probiotics, lots of research out of probiotics. They help keep your gut healthy and happy. So we have bad bacteria that lives in us, but it's supposed to, it's gotta be there. The good bacteria that you take in as a probiotic helps to fight back the amount of growth of the bad bacteria that we have. However, the good bacteria don't live inside you. You have to invite them in. Whether you take a probiotic or you eat servings of sauerkraut or kimchi or kombucha, something that's been fermented, okay? Yogurt will work too. So you definitely want to make sure you get those good bacteria in there so your digestion works properly. I notice when I do and when I do not have my probiotics. Big difference in the whole processing part of things. Okay, then 10, always drink a pre-post workout shake or have some branched chain amino acid complex drink within 30 minutes of finishing. Okay, so here's the thing. If you're not much of shakes, that's okay. I just need you to have some sort of simple carbohydrate with a little bit of protein. Okay? But the shakes that we have, the foreign shakes, really good quality, the dot fit, really yummy taste, they help you get fast-acting proteins and carbohydrates into your body for that repair. There's a metabolic window. It's kind of a repair window right after your workout, okay? It's really good to get that meal in within the first hour, ideally. 45 minutes to an hour is perfect. If you're going home and you're going to take a quick shower and you've got meal already made, you'll be fine. Remember, you do have a 2-hour window, but it helps to have that shake. Those of you who are doing early morning workouts, it's great to have the shake to sip on a little bit before and during your workout because your energy is going to be zero, and I need a little bit of that energy in you for some of the weights we're going to be lifting, okay? What's that?
Premier Protein.
Premier Protein, like from Costco? Yeah, that should be fine. A lot of the things with the protein powders are you gotta find things that taste good for you, that you like, and if you're curious about the ingredients, bring in a label for either me or Brooke to look at, and I can point out things that would be like, well, this is one thing that you might wanna watch for, or yep, this looks pretty good. So yeah, a lot of people like the Premier Proteins. The ones that are already, yeah, and that's totally fine too. There's some shakes that are already pre-made, and some people like that for the ease of use, and that's totally okay, yeah. Lastly, we want to make sure that you are journaling. We do give you 2 weeks of journaling in your book to do, okay? After that, we're going to ask you to go to a checklist, and we make it a little bit easier. But why journal? I know it's tedious, but we kind of need to see what we're putting in our mouths. Sometimes we can add stuff in when we're walking and not realize that we actually ate it, right? So sometimes it's just a check and balance system. How much am I actually putting in? What am I actually eating? Let's just check myself on this. So we got a 2-week food log in there, but now we're not total sticklers. We want you to enjoy life, right? So we're gonna challenge you to a 10% splurge rule, okay? 90% 3 to 4 meals a day, 7 days a week, then you can splurge about one meal per week. If you're eating 4 to 5 meals a day, 7 days a week, you can splurge between 2 to 3 meals. So basically, you give yourself a cheat meal, one to three cheat meals, depending on how many times a day you eat, okay? Or a cheat snack. So that allows you to still have something that you like without feeling guilty about it. You can say, my trainer said this is okay. As long as it's the exception that you're having the treat and not the rule, okay? 80-20 works also. If you're not ready to go 90-10, 80. Yeah. 80-20 works too. So that would almost give you a little treat per day. That's another one that helps. But you gotta find out what kind of person are you. Do you need to have a little bit of something per day? Or are you the kind of person that needs to have a splurge Sunday or splurge Saturday where you can eat clean for 6 days or really well for 6 days, and then you need to have one day where you kind of just refeed your body, okay? So figure out what kind of person you are and how it's gonna work best, all right? Okay, that's it. Those are the basic rules that if you're not ready to do Whole30, that's okay. You can follow just the basic rules. You can also do, if you're not ready to do the full Whole30, maybe you pick one item to take out. Maybe you just take out dairy or grains, and so don't feel like it's either A or B. Make this work for you. We want you to challenge yourself nutritionally, but you got to find where your heart's at and where your mind's at when you're ready for it. Thanks, guys. I'm going to hand it back over to Brooke.
Can you draw the first two things?
Oh, drawing. Did everybody get their name on a card for the drawing?
There's something that you're like, no, I can't do that. I
problematic. So you will learn how the foods you've been eating are actually affecting your day-to-day life. You don't realize you're not feeling awesome. This feeling of just okay becomes the norm. And every day you wake up, you have maybe a little digestive issues, or your skin's kind of breaking out, and you just feel kind of lethargic. And then until you really eliminate those foods, you don't know how amazing you can feel. So this whole 30 really can change your life. It will change the way you think about food, it will change your taste, it will change your habits and your cravings, it will restore a healthy emotional relationship with food, with your body, and really has the potential to really change the way you eat for the rest of your life. So whole 30, Amy mentioned it starts with food. Highly recommend that if you want to know your question. If you really want to know the reason why we are eliminating some of these foods, read that. It kind of puts everything into perspective. And so really it outlines kind of the four food good standards. So number one is we want food to promote a healthy psychological response. Food shouldn't initiate some of that bad relationship or those cravings. Two, food should help promote a healthy hormonal response. And three, support a healthy gut. And four, support your immune function and minimize inflammation. So I'm going to go back to one. So unhealthy relationship with food. So the goal is to promote a healthy psychological response to the food. So trying to eliminate those trigger foods. We all know those foods where once you start eating, you can't stop. And so once we eliminate those foods and not relying on foods that, you know, help us when you're stressed or lonely or anxious or unhappy. And so think of this next 30 days really as just a science experiment. I'm trying to figure this out, kind of how foods affect you. So the whole 30 rules are really created to eliminate those unhealthy cravings. Other sources of comfort and reward. So everyone should have had the non-scale victory handouts. So instead of relying on getting on that scale or that relationship with food, trying to focus on other things that are going to make you happy. They're in the back. I don't know if anybody got one. So number two, the whole 30 is going to help you with a sluggish metabolism. So right now, most of us are conditioned to rely on sugar for energy. But by eliminating those less healthy foods, you will start to restore a healthy hormonal balance. You'll regulate your blood sugar, become fat adapted, using your body fat for fuel, increase energy, reduction in hunger between meals, and weight loss. And then three, a disruptive digestive system. So a lot of the foods we eat, especially grains, cause us to have a leaky gut, which is where your small intestine is unable to absorb the nutrients you need. And once we eliminate those foods, we allow our gut to heal, and we start to fully absorb the nutrients our bodies need. And then number four, most of us suffer from chronic systematic inflammation. So our immune system's top priority is defense against outside threats, like fighting off a cold or healing tissues when you sprain your ankle. So your immune system is usually aggressive but short-term. It recognizes a threat, rapidly ramps up to deal with it, and then once the job is done, goes back to a resting baseline. But what happens when our body is always fighting off? It's called a systematic inflammation, and it starts in your gut, which causes your body to be in chronic inflammation. And it's working overtime. And now it can't focus and heal itself from a simple cold. And now you have tendonitis or joint pains, and you develop allergies, and you have asthma. So by letting that immune system heal and actually work like it's supposed to. So what are the rules? So number one is no sugar. So there's another addicted to sugar. The best way to break the addiction is to eliminate it completely. So we're not consuming any added sugar, real or artificial. So no maple syrup, honey, agave nectar, coconut sugar, date syrup, Splenda, Equo, all those. So read your labels, because companies sneak sugar into products in ways you might not recognize. And so this sugar thing, this is one I kind of fight with a little bit. So like, you know, if you're doing, like I accidentally got some chicken broth when I was doing the Whole30. More sugar in my chicken broth, are you kidding me? But I had already used it. So a lot of times in these rules of Whole30, it says if you break them, you have to start over. The rebel in me said no. So I'm gonna let you guys kind of do that on your own. I mean, that's just a tiny bit of sugar. It's not, in my professional opinion, that's not gonna ruin your Whole30. So just try and be aware as much as you can. Try and eliminate that added sugar as much as you can. If you get some sausage, it might have a little bit of sugar. It's okay. Yes.
So one of the parts for you to say is like try to pull the sugar alcohol, but that's also that's in sugar-free gum.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a
go ahead, Karen.
two is kind of goes with meal prep is food prep. Get yourself a grocery list, go to the grocery store. Your first time going to the grocery store doing Whole 30 can be a little intimidating. It might take a little while because you're reading those labels. But once you've done that first trip and you figure out all the ones that you need, what you can and can't do, then it'll be a lot easier. But give yourself patience, time, maybe get some headphones, listen to some music, focus, and just have fun at the grocery store when you can. And just read some labels and just know it's going to take a little while that first trip on a Whole 30. Expectations, right? Yes, Katie.
You need to, you know, after my car day, you pretty much might have this no being
Yeah. And then, so when you're at the grocery store, food prep, cooking just a big batch of chicken, your roasted veggies, double, triple the amount that you normally would have. And then you have those leftovers for the week. Boil some eggs, cut up all your veggies. If you need to, pay extra for already pre-cut veggies or those already made cauliflower rice. And that way it's one less step you have to do. If that's going to help you succeed in your Whole 30, do it. And then keep it simple. Meat, veggie, fat. It doesn't have to be super fancy. So you can eat the same thing for 3 days in a row. 4 days in a row. Just keep it simple. And then invest in some spices and sauces. So one thing,
there is three great books that Melissa wrote, The Ritual One with Her Husband, and then she's got a cookbook, and then there's another intro book. I have them, and I will bring them in. I have the Food Freedom Diary book, and so I'll bring those in and leave them on the table up there for you guys to look at. As like Karen found out, I spoke with Karen, and she went ahead and got the basic Whole 30 book. There's a lot of recipes in there, and she has already dog-eared all the different recipes. And Karen and I were talking, and like what Brooke was saying about food lagging, when you pick the same foods over and over again, that's how you kind of survive this. You find your main 15 foods, and you just keep cycling through those for the 30 days. So, yeah, it's not really as hard as it seems. It's more of us letting go of our emotional connection to the food. But I did it, and I had quite a bit of success with it. And you do switch. You start really reading labels, and you start going, wow, I can't believe how much stuff is in, how much they sneak sugar in a little bit of everything. And you just start becoming a little bit more aware of what's in your food. And that's really kind of what this helps you with, too, is being aware of what you're putting in, making sure you're buying the best things. Trader Joe's is a great list, a great grocery list, by the way, online, of Whole 30 approved foods. So
one of the season themes I love is called 21 Season Salute. It's from Trader Joe's, but they also have it at Costco. They think of it as just called 21 Seasons. Wonderful. Another dressing that I love from Trader Joe's is called Green Goddess Salad Dressing. It's in the refrigerated section. And then you can have guacamole. If you're like, what do I dip it in? You can't have corn chips, but you can have cucumbers, use your carrots. So you can have guacamole, salsa. Yes.
Another great seasoning, you can't get it in stores, you can order it online, it's Flavor God. It's all freshly packed, everything, and there's no added sugars or anything in it. They're great.
Yes.
They're
yes.
delicious.
Yeah. Other seasonings too is this Primal Palette and the Primal Kitchen. These two have some awesome seasonings there. And then you can also go to Thrive Market. I believe you have to have a subscription, but it's delivered, and they have, you can just type in Whole 30, and it's all these products that are Whole 30 approved, shipped to your door, good to go. So you can get ketchup, you can get mayo, you can get a lot of different sauces that are Whole 30 approved that really help that you don't feel like you're missing out on some things. Salsa, you can have another thing at Trader Joe's, which is called, it's kale, cashew, basil get at Trader Joe's, which is delicious.
Chomps. Like Chomps. C-H-O-M-P-S.
Okay.
Like you're chomping on
it. And these are at the register where you buy them, at Trader Joe's.
But the ones that we have here, the ones that you can
they order. Have my comfort.
Oh, they do.
So technically, they're not both 30 approved. I say closer. We have a growth mindset,
But if you guys don't want to do that, that's okay. And a lot of that comes in with our spouse. So if they're not willing to jump on that bandwagon so you don't get that flack from them or feel hurt that they're not supporting you, you got to let them know, I need to do this for me. If you'd like to come on this journey with me, that's great. If not, I'll still support you in what kind of foods you would like to have. But I ask that you help support me too in this. What else? I really enjoyed it. What's interesting with this is when we add the foods back in, you're going to test to see how your body responds to it. My sister found out that she can't do dairy, right? Pretty obvious, a lot of us can't. But for her, grains were not an issue. Bread was not an issue, but rice was. So years before, she'd been told, get off bread, go gluten-free. So she was eating rice, and she was just still sick and not doing well. She got rid of the dairy. When she did this, she found out, oh my gosh, my body doesn't digest rice, but she can eat bread. So go figure, her body does not have an intolerance to the gluten. So it's really neat to kind of see what does my body really react to. And it's going to take about 3 days. Like when you put that dairy back in, you have to give yourself 3 days to see if you have a migraine. So that third day, a migraine may come in and you can sit there and go, oh, I had that cottage cheese on Monday. Huh. See what I'm saying? So with a lot of times we're like, well, what is that migraine coming from? Those of us who suffer from migraines, a lot of it's food related. What else? Mindset. So one little trick I do, which is not really what Melissa Hartwig encourages, but you know when you feel like you need a little treat, but you want to stay Whole30 approved, I would go to Trader Joe's and buy 100% cacao bar. Yeah, I'm talking 100%, okay? It's just cocoa, basically, in a bar. But they make it the size of a small candy bar, so it's small and breakable versus like Baker's chocolate. I would take a piece of that and I would put it into a date. And then I'd eat 2 macadamia nuts. So the flavor profile that I get in my mouth is a chocolate essence, right? I get the sweetness from the date and the buttery richness from the macadamia nuts. And that was a little treat or a snack that I would do for myself. And I still do it. It became a fun thing for me to do and a much healthier thing than going and getting a candy bar, right? So little things like that will help me get through.
And I'll be sending out weekly emails encouraging you what to expect if you're on that Whole30, how you should probably be feeling, things like that. So open those emails. If you're not getting them, let me know. Talk to your trainer. Make sure we get you on that email list. And then we have two more. We have our Action Multivitamin and our Omega 3. So this is for our Omega 3.
The two companies that we have are DotFit and Thorn Research. I did a lot of research to make sure that we had top quality, Becky Baker, that we have top quality supplements. Thorn Research is a very premier line. DotFit is also a very great company, run small, mom and pop. They put what's on the label is what's inside their vitamins, okay? So we're not getting fillers, we're not getting things that are not gonna suit your body well. It's the actual supplement is full of those ingredients. I was really picky about what supplements we use. I'm okay if you guys wanna use outside resources. You don't have to use the supplements we sell here, but I can tell you they are definitely high quality and I back them 100% with what they are. If you have questions about the supplements you have at